Now let's test our new login API. We're going to test our login API using Chrome. So before we do that, let's make sure our development server is running. Log into the Vagrant server and work on the profiles API virtual environment, and then change to the /vagrant/src/profiles project location. And then type python manage.py run server 0.0.0.0:8080 and hit enter. Once your server is up and running, you can minimize the Git bash and load up Chrome. Then head over to 127.0.0.1:8080/API and hit enter. You can see that the login API has been added to our API route. This is why we create a login API as a view set instead of as an API view, because that way we can add it to this API route. Click on the URL here for the login API. The login API, it says when you go to the page and do a HTTP GET, it returns a HTTP 405 method not allowed. And that's because you can't call HTTP GET on a login API. You can only call a HTTP POST to log in. In the username, let's enter the username of the user we created as our super user. So the username is the email address that we use to register. Because we're using the built-in serializer of the REST framework, so we don't have to write all the logic ourselves, unfortunately, we can't change this name from username to email address very easily. So it needs to be the username field that we put the email in. Type the username as mark@londonappdeveloper.com, or whichever username you signed up with when you created the super user account. And I'm gonna put in the password awesome1 with a capital A. And then hit post. What it's gonna do now is gonna post this username and password to the server, and it's gonna generate a temporary token that we can use to authenticate with the other APIs. This is the token here. We're gonna need this token in the next lesson, so make sure you keep it handy. So that's how you log in using our new login API. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson.